Welcome everyone on the webinar. We shall now proceed for this webinar, and we will be talking about options and how you can trade options, and also the objective is to really spend the time and help all of you become a professional in options trading. So professional is a very, I would say, a very strong word. But what I mean by it is that no one is born a professional. All of a sudden, one becomes a professional over a period of time when one really commits to it. So my objective in this webinar is to ensure that all of you who are here on the webinar get started thinking in the right way, and also help you really understand how options are to be traded. So I'll be talking about the crux of options, and I will be looking at that. So the structure of the webinar is going to be that first of all, it will be mastering the basic nuts and bolts of options trading. What exactly are the basic nuts and bolts? Then understanding how options are different than stocks, and also gain practical insight into which options to trade successfully. And the fourth is what you definitely shouldn't do while trading options. So these are the four areas which I will be covering. So before I get into that, I would like to tell you that think of futures and options trading as a game, the highest stakes money game in the world, where fortunes are made and lost daily. You can trade both the long and the short of the market, squaring off your trade as and when you like. Luck might play a part in the short term, but in the end, only those players who play the game better will triumph. No method is foolproof, but my endeavor is to help you to place the odds in your favor. So ultimately, acting in a disciplined manner holds the key to success. So it's all about having a discipline in trading, whether you're trading the cash segment, whether you're trading options, whether you're trading futures. So looking at the basic nuts and bolts of options trading, I'll spend a couple of minutes, and I've made the presentation very practical, and also you'll find that you learn really a lot on options. So just to on the basic nuts and bolts of options trading. Options are basically contracts that give the buyers the right, but not the obligation, to buy or sell a specified underlying at a set price on or before a specified date. So what you really need to remember is that options are that gives you the right, but not the obligation if you're buyer of options. But if you're a seller of options, then you are definitely obligated. So there are two types of options. You have the call option, you have the put option. You'll find that many a times it's mentioned as CE and PE. So C stands for call, and E stands for European. So CE stands for call European style, and PE stands for put European style. So when you're bullish on the market, you will buy a call option. When you're bearish on the market, you will buy a put option. Those who are writing options, what they will do is they will do just the reverse. When they are bearish on the market, they will sell a call option, and when they are bullish on the market, they will sell a put option. So it's just a reverse of what you are doing. So if you are buying a call option, that means you are bullish on the market. If you are buying a put option, you are bearish on the market. If you just look at the Nifty 50 of 30th November 2017. So here you find that you have this option of Nifty index option of strike price 10,250. So you can see that at point of time, this is a call option, and that was trading at 28.15. Whereas if you look at the high of the day, was 71.7. If you look at the previous close, that was 113.9, and the low was 22. So what I'm trying to really tell you here is that you can see the volatility that is there in options. So yesterday the closing was at 113.9. At 1 o'clock, it was the same option was trading at 28.15. and during the day it had made a high of 72. So you see that in volatile situations or in volatile market conditions, options premium fluctuates significantly. So if you know how to really trade options, there is a very good possibility that you could really end up making good money. But at the same time, you should also remember that if you are on the wrong foot, if you are caught on the wrong foot, you should act as a professional. And I will tell you what I mean by that. So now we will look at just an example of option as to, we'll take an example. Say for example, there are two individuals, Harish. Harish is one who trades basically in Nifty futures. So he's gone long in Nifty futures. That is, he has bought a Nifty future at 10,000 levels. Whereas Manish, he trades in options, and he is also bullish on the market, and he's bought a call option at 100 when the premium is 100 for a 10,000 strike. Now, if the market falls, we look at both scenarios. If the market first falls by 100 points, then if the market falls by 100 points, then Harish loses 75 into 100, that is 7,500, by trading in Nifty futures, because the Nifty lot size is 75. Whereas if we look at Manish loses 75 into 65, that is, he loses 4,875 by trading in Nifty options. So in this case, the option has a delta of 0.65. So I'll be talking about what the Greeks are, some of the key Greeks that you should be looking at, where you can find them. I'll be talking about all that as well. So what you need to understand here is that in the case of the futures trade, the loss is 7,500, but in the case of an options trade, the loss is 4,875. Another point I would like to add here is that if you are an option buyer, that is either a call option or a put option, your loss is restricted maximum to the option premium that you pay. But if you are trading futures, your loss can be unlimited, because Nifty, say for example, the first falls by 100 points, and then it could fall the same day by another 50 points or 100 points. So the fall could be significant. So your loss also could be higher if you're trading futures. But in options, you know that what is the premium that you have paid. In this case, the premium that you have paid was 7,500. So that is the maximum loss that you would incur. Now, just let us take the other side of the trade, that Nifty rises up by 100 points. So 10,100 becomes 10,000 becomes 10,100. So on the futures side, Harish gains 7,500. I have taken an investment amount of 50,000 for the futures if he's trading. So his return on investment is 15%. Whereas Manish, who has bought the 10,000 strike call option for a premium of 100, that is 7,500. So he makes 4,875 on an investment of 7,500. So he has a 65% return on an investment of 7,500 by trading options. The point what I'm trying to say is that option offers you extremely high leverage compared to futures. So you can take advantage of it, you can get hit. But if you, and believe me, the best of the best traders also, they have trades going wrong, but they know what to do when they are wrong. That's something which is very important. And secondly, they never take such a huge bet on one particular trade, that one particular trade going wrong can really hit them very hard, both financially and psychologically, that they are not able to come back in the game once again. So the point here is to limit the losses and how to take the right trades. So now we'll just briefly talk about what's intrinsic value and what's time value. So generally you'll find that the option premium that you pay is a combination of the intrinsic value and the time value. So option value is intrinsic value plus time value. And the intrinsic value, I'll just explain with an example, that would be even better, but just let me explain here. That intrinsic value is the difference between the strike price and the current market price. And intrinsic value is always found in ITM options, that is in the money options. OTM options, that is out of money options, have zero intrinsic value. And also what we see is that the time value premium decreases at an accelerated rate as the option approaches maturity. So if we look at an option which is approaching maturity, you might find that you have bought a call option or you have bought a put option and the market is moving in your favor but not moving fast in your favor. So what you will find that in spite of the market moving in your favor, the option premium is not increasing for you. That is, you are not making money either on the call side or on the put side. Why? Because the time decay, or which is also called the theta, is eating into the option premium that is approaching towards maturity. So that is the reason if you buy and hold an option for a long period of time, you will not make money. So it's very important that timing of options becomes very crucial, and their technical analysis can help you significantly. Also, I'll tell what are the other things that you should pay attention to. So now we just look at this table. I'll explain to you the intrinsic value, the premium value, and the time value. So here what happens, we'll just take one example. Here the futures is trading at 8,400. So we see the first, if you look at the, so if we so if we look at the futures here, we are seeing that it is 8,400, and if we are looking at this option which is at 8,100 call option. So this is the 8,100 call option. So if you see that the premium in this case is 340 and the intrinsic value is 300, which is the difference between this strike price and the current market price, that is the future price. So you find that the intrinsic value in this case is 8,400 minus 8,100, that is 300. So the total premium is 340. So the balance, that is 340 minus 300, which is your 40, is your time value. So what you find is that from 8,100 call option, we go to 8,200 call option, 8,300, 400, 500, 600, 700. So what we see is that as we go towards 8,200, in this case, the premium becomes 260. In 8,300, the premium becomes 185. In 8,400, this is the premium becomes 120, and then you find that as we go out of money, that is 8,500 call option, 8,600 call option, 8,700 call option. So they are all out of money. Why? Because the futures, if you look at the futures is at 8,400. So here this strike 8,400 call is at the money. So anything above that for the call option is out of money. So out of money, as we can see, is again at the money and out of money. They all have intrinsic value, which is zero. So it is only the in the money options have intrinsic value. So you can see an intrinsic value, as I said, is the difference between the strike price and the market price. So in this case, what is the strike price? 8,200. What is the futures price? 8,400. That is a CMP. So 8,400 minus 8,200 is your 200. So you can see that here the premium for that 8,200 call option is 260 and intrinsic value is 200. So the time value is 60. So it's very simple. You don't need to get much confused on that. We'll just take another example. Now we'll take a put example. So what you need to remember is that for call options to be in the money, the strikes have to be lower than the current market price. Any strike which is higher than the current market price is out of money. But that is just the reverse for a put option. So here you can see in the put option, here you can see on the put option that the 8,500 strike price, 8,600 strike price, and 8,700 strike price, they are the ones that have time value, that is intrinsic value. They have intrinsic value. So again here the intrinsic value is what? The difference between the strike price and the futures price. So 8500 minus 8400, that is 100. 8600 minus 8400 is 200, and 8700 minus 8400 is 300. So what remains is the time value. So 180 minus 100 is 80, 250 minus 200 is 50, and 320 minus 300 is 20. So what you need to remember, it's very simple, that for call options to be in the money, all the strikes which are below the market price, they are in the money, and any calls which is above the market price, that is out of money. And it is simply the reverse for the put options. So put options, all the strikes which are above the market price, they are in the money, and all which are below or at are, you can say, out of money. So in this case, if you see 8400 put option, intrinsic value is zero. For 8400 call option also, intrinsic value is zero, because these are at the money. And here you can see that these are out of money. So generally what you will find is that out of money options have very low premium as compared to in the money options. And as you move deeper in the money options, you will find that the option premium increases. Now in this example, you can see that 8400 put option, the premium is 120, and 8700 put option, the premium is 320. So you, if you are buying an 8700 premium, you have to pay a larger amount. So this 320 needs to be multiplied by the lot size. So in Nifty, the case is 75. The lot size is 75. So you have to multiply 320 into 75. So that is the total premium that you have to pay to buy a 8700 put option. So I hope you all are clear on now the intrinsic value and the time value. So now we'll look at, this is what I was talking about earlier. So here also it is clarified that in the money for a call option, that the market price is more than the strike price. So all the strikes are lower in the case of in the money of an option, for a call option. At the money is the same as the strike price, and out of money, wherein we have that the market price of the underlying asset is less than the strike price. So it is just the opposite in case of put option, which I had explained in my earlier example. So we will just look at, I want to give you some view also as to how to really look at it, because I've been talking about it, but where can you see, how do you see, those are certain queries which would be in your mind. So so for those who are using our Speed Pro application, for them we have our Angel Advanced chart is there, so you can use that as well. This screenshot which you see is from our Angel Advanced charting application, which not only gives you real-time data feed of all the NSE stocks, but also provides you data feed of NSE futures, NSE options, and also for the currency segment. So here what you see is that this option chain in the money, if we look at this the first line, first row, what I have put here is you can see here that Nifty is at 10,275. So what it means is that 10,250 strike, which is lower than the strike price, lower than the current market price, then 10,200 is lower than the current market price, then 10,000. So these are all in the money. So the Nifty premium for these options, you can see that the premium for 10,250 was 31, for 10,200 was 73. So for 10,000 it was 270. Likewise, if I'm looking at the put option, so in this case, all the strikes which are higher than the current market price, they are in the money for a put option. So here it becomes 10,300 put option, 10,350 put option, 10,400 put option. And all these options which are there, they have different strikes. So in Nifty, the strike varies by 50 points. So you have to, for stocks, for each and every stock, it is different. So you need to understand that. You also need to know what is the lot size of that particular option which you are trading, because that should not come as a surprise to you once you have taken your position. So what I want to show here is that you can find all of this information, and also NSE website, you can get all the information on that on the website very easily, and also on the Angel mobile app you can get the information and the prices for these particular options. So what I'm trying to say is that this is how you can look at the in the money option. There's something called the IV, that is the implied volatility. We have the delta, gamma, rho, theta. So I'll be talking about some of them which are important for you to remember. So in this case, as I said, the in the money options for the call as well as for the put, this I've explained. So for all the call options, the strikes which are lower than the current market price, that was 10,275, they are in the money. And for put options, all the strikes which are higher than the current market price, they are in the money. So that's the reason you will find that in the money options are comparatively higher price as compared to out of money options. So now we will look at some of the out of money options. So here you can see the difference, that here the premium is 11 rupees, 1 rupee 70 paise, 0.45 paise, 30 paise, 1.757.50. But you look at it, that in all these cases, if you look at this, so the, what is the strike? The strike is higher than the current market price. The current market price is what? 10,278. But what is this option price? Option strike is 10,400, 10,350, 10,300. So 10,300 has higher premium as compared to 10,400. What it means is that 10,400, if someone wants to buy, he just has to pay 0.45 multiplied by 75. So that's the money that he has to pay, roughly around 30 rupees or so, to buy one option. So the point what I want to convey here is, just because the premium is 45 paise or 1 rupee 70 paise or 11 rupees and they are out of money options, call options, you simply shouldn't go and buy them, because very likelihood you might not be able to make any money on this, and this is very close to the expiry. So that's the reason these options are even are so cheap. So and if you look at the put option, so in this case you look at the put, all the puts which are below the strikes, they are out of money. So the 10,250 put, the 10,200 put, the 10,100 put. So you see that the 10,100 put option for Nifty, the premium is 0.3. So 0.3 into 75, that's 20 rupees or so. So the next one is 1.55, the next one is 7.5. So they seem to be very cheap. So many people who really don't understand, they find that, oh, it's so cheap, I should buy them. But that's not a good idea. Until unless you don't have a very valid reason why you should buy these so cheap options, I would say that you should rather stay away from them. So then I will, later in this webinar, I'll talk about which are the options that you should really trade. So I was showing you here that we have, you have the delta, you have the gamma, you have the rho, you have the theta. These are the Greeks which are there for options. So I'll be talking about two of them. And we have other webinars also wherein we will have one webinar specifically on option Greeks only, which will cover nothing but option Greeks. Then we'll have some, we'll have another webinar which will be on advanced trading strategies. So on options. So we will be, and I would request all of you that those who are interested, you should definitely attend them from time to time. It will help you. So now coming to delta, what exactly is delta? It's very simple. Don't get confused by the terms. Delta refers to the percentage move the option registers in comparison to its underlying. So with an example, it will be clear. So don't worry. Its value ranges from 0 to 1. So for very deep out of money options, the delta can be 0, and for very deep in the money options, the delta can be 1, which behave very much like the underlying. So we'll just look at the previous examples so you'll get an idea. So if we look at the 10,000 call option, when Nifty call option, when Nifty was trading at 10,275, you see what is the delta? The delta is 1. That means it is more or less trading as the futures only. So a delta of 1 is generally for deep in the money options. So So here you can see the delta which is there. Now if we look at the out of money options, deep out of money options, what you are seeing, the delta for deep out of money options are 10,400 call options, the delta is 0.02, and the delta for a 10,100 put option is minus 0.01. So for the call options, the delta is positive. For put options, the delta is negative. So here what it effectively means is that if a stock option has a delta value of 0.65, it means that if the underlying stock price rises by rupees 1 per share, the option on it will rise by 0.65 rupees per share. So it is that if Nifty moves up by 1 point and if the delta of that Nifty option is 0.5, that means the option will move up by 0.5. So the option premium will move up by 0.5. So that is what you need to understand. So you should look at trading those options which have a higher delta, at least 0.6, 0.7. Avoid trading options which have a delta of less than that, because the probability and the possibility of your making money reduces significantly. So this is one important takeaway for all of you. The next is something that you should look at. Many a times we have that query that I have bought an option and price is not going anywhere, but my option premium is decaying. My option premium is declining. Why is that? To just give an example, if you buy a futures contract on Nifty when Nifty is at 10,000 the market closes for 3 consecutive days at the same level at 10,000. So you're not making a profit, you're not making a loss. But say, for example, you have bought a Nifty call option or a Nifty put option, just whatever, and you have bought it when it was at 10,000, and after 3 days also it is at 10,000. So your option premium is not going to remain the same. So had you paid a premium of 100, so that premium maybe would decline to 90 or 95 or whatever. It depends upon the time to expiry which is there and other factors which are there, like gamma and vega and delta. So the point what I'm trying to say is that theta basically is an option's rate of decay over time. How much is the option going to decay over a period of time? So generally it is suggested that one should not hold options for very long. Don't you just buy an option and hold it till expiry? Because I come across many people who simply buy an option and they keep on holding till the expiry, and then they say that the option is not making money. The option will never make money if you keep on simply buying and holding the option, because every day the theta is working against you, the time decay is working against you, and that is working 24/7. So it is not advisable for you to simply buy and hold. That's why I said, if you're trading options, having some idea of technical analysis, having some idea of some major events can work in your favor. Then we have some other Greeks like gamma and vega. So we will cover them in detail, greater detail, with examples in our other webinar that we'll be having on only specifically on option Greeks. So here you can see now that the theta in this case, if we look at the theta in this case for the Nifty 10,300 call option was minus 9, that is, it was to decay by 9 points, and then for the 10,350 was to decay by 3.57 points. So the theta basically is a reflection of the decay rate of the option over a period of time. Next, the question comes is, why trade options? Why people are interested in trading options? Or if you see the volumes also on the exchanges, almost 70% of the volumes that happens on the exchanges, that is on NSE, is in options, and that also primarily in Nifty and Bank Nifty options. Bank Nifty weekly option again is something which has become very popular once it was launched. Now it will be it's very popular. So the reasons why options are traded is, one is that it is an effective hedge. options can be used to protect existing positions. So if you are having an existing position either in a futures market or in a cash segment, you can take an offsetting position in the options. Say for example, you have a position in for example ACC. Now what we saw in ACC, that ACC prices corrected significantly. Now you have a cash position in ACC or you have a futures position in ACC. Now you don't want to exit your position. You want to hold your position because you feel that maybe there could be further upside to it. But you really don't know that maybe some event could happen and markets are trading very high, or there could be some negative news that could come in. So you want to protect yourself. So there are good ways. You could buy a ACC put option. So that would, in case the market would correct, you would gain on the put, but at the same time you would be losing on your investment. But that would more or less compensate with the profit that you would make in the options. Likewise, if you don't want to buy a put, you could sell a call option, because buying a call option is bullish, so selling a call option is bearish. But you need to remember that when you are selling off or selling options, the premium that you pay, the margin that you pay is significantly higher, because that margin almost corresponds to your futures margin as compared to you're buying an option. Because when you're buying an option, the premium is very less as compared to selling an option. So it can be an effective hedge, but this is generally it is very useful if you want to hold on to your position and there is some major event that is to happen. You don't know what that event could do to your position, so you want to take a insurance sort of, so you can buy an option and a reverse option. So if you are long on that particular stock, you can buy a put option. Then what you need to do is options provide attractive returns. Here the margin deployed or the capital deployed is very minuscule, so the leverage can be very high. So what we saw here is that you could just to go back and give you an example. Let's say for example you have bought a Nifty 10,150 option or 10,200 option at 1.55. It is possible that if Nifty were to witness a significant correction, and then your 1.55 could even become 20, 30, 40. So the possibility is huge for making money, but the loss remains limited to the option premium that you pay. So the next is limited risk. Since an option has an inherent hedge, in its losses are limited to the premium paid as compared to the unlimited loss in a futures position. So this is a major advantage of trading options, that your loss is limited no matter which way the market moves. If it goes significantly against you, then also the market, you are protected. Only drawback is two things. One is that if you keep on holding your option position for a long period of time, theta will eat up the option premium. And secondly, if you buy a very low delta option, then even if the market moves significantly, you might not make too much of money. So you have to be careful as to which options you buy. Then options have lower risk and high volatility. So volatility, what I showed in the earlier one of the charts, is if you look at Nifty in this particular case, what we saw was that the previous close was 114 and the next day's low was 22, and at that point of time it was trading at 28. So see the volatility, and during the same day also it made a high of 7170. So it becomes very important and crucial as to when you are buying options, for how long you are buying options, and what is the reason you are buying options. So somewhere or the other, using technicals, if you use technicals, it can really help you understand the markets well. Then options you can trade in all markets, be it trending markets or be it trendless markets. So you can trade options. Then we come to another important point, is understand how options are different than stocks. In stocks, what happens is that you have a buy and hold. You can simply buy and hold the stock for days, for weeks, for months and years, decades. So you can simply buy and hold as long as the company is there. You can simply buy and hold. But options are derivative instruments. So you can't hold them forever. They have expiry dates. So you have to square them off. Or in case you want to hold your position, you roll over your position. That means you square off this position, build up a position in the next month's contract, next month's contract. Again, you have to choose the which strike you want to enter into. So you will have to do that to hold your position. So that's a major difference. So stocks are primarily meant for investing, whereas options are primarily used for hedging and trading. Stocks also you can trade, but what I mean here is that more majorly it's for investing, but options are primarily for hedging and trading. Options is not for investing. That's something you should really understand very clear. It's for trading or hedging. That means you have to have a view and you have to have a reason why you have that view. Then stocks are non-leveraged. So you don't generally take leverage on the stocks, whereas options are highly leveraged. The leverage could be 1 to 100, 1 to 300 also, depending upon what is the premium that you are paying for that particular option. So just to give an example, if Nifty is at 10,000 and the lot size is 75, so the contract value is how much? 10,000 into 75, that is 7,50,000. Now suppose you are buying an option of Nifty by paying a premium of 20. So 20 into 75, that is the lot size. So you pay a premium of how much? 1500 rupees. And what is the contract value? 7,50,000. So if you divide 7,50,000 by 1500, you get 500. So the leverage in that case becomes 1:500. So what I'm trying to say is that options offer you the highest leverage which you can really imagine or think. So you can make huge money, while at the same time, if you don't protect yourself, if you simply go on writing options, selling options without really understanding what the options are, then if there is a major move on one particular day, all the money that you've been made by simply writing options one day, you can lose all that money. So you need to understand all that very clear. So we'll be talking about those strategies also in our options webinars. So because we'll be having a series of webinars on options. So if trading in stocks can be said to equal to driving a car, then trading in options can be compared to flying an aeroplane. Both are world apart. I'm not trying to frighten you. I'm just trying to tell you that trading in options can be very exciting, because flying an aeroplane is also very exciting. If you are well prepared, if you are experienced, if you take all the precautions, then flying an aeroplane is a dream for everyone. So the same is with options as well. Now we will look at gain practical insights, because till now I was talking to you about which are the type of options, where you should look at them. But now I'll tell you exactly which options you should trade to trade successfully. I've also put in here a chart here. I'll explain that as well, how you can also look at it, where you will find all this data. So the first is stay away from deep ITM, that is deep in the money option. Now, if you look at this particular chart which I have put in, this is a call option. This is a option chain for the Nifty. If you look at Nifty, the strike price here is 9,350 and here the strike price is 10,300. So I've just taken almost 1,000 points for Nifty. So you'll see that every strike varies from the other by a 50 point. So now you just remember what all I have said. So if you see the call option and you look at this LTP column, so you have 905, 807, 698, 603, 505, 444, and here you have 18.65. So in this case you will find that when here Nifty was close to 10,270 to 80 levels. So in this case, the 10,300 call option was trading at 18.65 and the 10,250 was trading at 54. So as you go from here to here, you will find this way, you will find that as you're going deep in the money option, so you just look at the premium that you're paying. So if you buy a, for example, a 9,400 call strike Nifty, you are paying a premium of 900 multiplied by 75. So that is the premium that you pay. But and see, there are some volumes also which have happened. But ideally, you should not be trading these. So the point what I'm trying to say is that, and this I have taken from the NSE website. You can have a look at for any stock that you wish to trade. You can get all this there. If you have queries, please write to us at here we have at below webinars. We have here webinars at the rate angelbroking.com. You can write to us. We'll definitely revert back to you. So what you can see here is that these are deep in the money options. In this case, we are getting deep in the money options. We have the 9,000. So if you buy a 9,500, 550 option here, we don't have liquidity. But if you buy a, say, for example, 9,600 option, you pay a premium of almost 700 multiplied by 75. So that's almost 50,000 plus rupees you are investing as a margin for buy an option worth 9,600 when Nifty is actually trading around 10,270 to 80. So that's deep in the money. So you can look at this. So the first is stay away from deep in the money options. Then the next is stay away from deep out of money option. If we look at these options, which are deep in the money, deep out of money options. If you look at these out of money options, so all those options which are above 10,300, so 10,350, 400, they are not deep out of money, but 10,600, 10,700, you will find options of 11,000 also, 11,500 also. So those are deep out of money. So you should stay away from them because there the premium is going to be very less. You might be interested to buy that option, but then that's not a good idea. So here the point is that buying deep out of money option gives you a lot of leverage, but in reality it just gives you a lot of hope, encourages over commitment, and generally offers little profit opportunity. So you find that the option is so cheap, let me buy it. So you pay a very small amount and you buy that option. But as I said, if you don't have a very valid reason why you are buying that particular option, you should not buy that option. The second thing is you should also look at the OI, this column which you see here, this particular column, OI column. Which contract has the maximum OI? Which strike has the highest volume? So those are certain options which you should ideally trade, because there the bid and ask spread will also be comparatively less. So here you can see that if you are buying this option, here the bid and ask is, bid is 18.45, ask is 18.65. Here it is 54.3, 54.6. But just look at this. If you are buying this 9,600, here the bid ask, I would say still it is quite liquid. That the bid is 700 and the ask is 704. So you can find that as well. So but in this case, if you look at it, there's no volume there, but in this case the bid is 681 and the ask is 828. So the point what I'm trying to say is that look at the options with strikes which have the highest volume, which have the highest OI. Those are the options that you generally should trade, and you will find that they are slightly in the money. They are not deep out of money, or they are neither deep in the money. So what are the options which you should ideally trade? So you should trade slightly out of money, at the money, or slightly in the money options. These are the options you should trade, because here you will find that you have the highest liquidity. So the bid and ask spread is in your favor. Secondly, the open interest is there, so you can carry forward your positions. And getting in and getting out is comparatively easy. Here I would want to add from a practical experience perspective that if you are trading options, if you're trading Nifty and Bank Nifty, then you really not be worried much on the liquidity, because you have tens of strikes which are liquid on either side. But if you're trading stock options, then you have to be really very careful, because there are close to 200 stocks which are there in the F&O category. But out of that, 60-70 would have decent options liquidity, and out of that 15-20 would have got good liquidity. So don't trade in options if the liquidity is very less. And the best thing is just compare the bid and ask spread. If there is a significant bid and ask spread, you should really think that is it a wise thing for you to buy. Because if the bid, if say for example the bid and ask the bid is 10 and the ask is suppose 16, in that case if you are buying, you are going to get at 16, and if you want to sell the next moment, you have to sell at 10. So effectively you are losing six rupees, but 6 rupees multiplied by the lot size. So if the lot size of that option contract is 1000, so effectively you are losing 6000 just by buying and selling. So that's something you should never ignore, because that's something which is very important. And the ones options which have the lowest bid and ask spread, they are the ones which are the most liquid that you should ideally trade. Here I have put a similar example for the puts. In the previous presentation slide, I had shown the calls. In this, I talk about puts. So again, in puts, you see we have the strikes of 10,000, 250, and all these. So here you find that puts, again as it is, puts which are above the strike price, they are in the money. So you will find that premiums have started increasing for the puts here, and it goes up to as much as 993. This I'm talking about the 11,300 put option. Here the volume is only less, so don't trade this. You should look at this. Okay, there's good volume in this, and you don't want to take a significant risk here, because it's closer to the expiry, so the premium is very less. But you can see that there's good volume, open interest. These are certain things you should definitely look at. There's a very nice saying that if you feel that knowledge is expensive, try ignorance. Because if you are into the game of futures and options, if you are into the game of trading, and if you don't know the rules of the game, if you don't know what's moving the market, then we all know who's going to lose. So there's no with internet and every information at our disposal, we don't have a reason to say that there's no one to teach us, or there's no one to help us. So if you have to trade, you should trade slightly out of money, at the money, or slightly in the money options. Then there is the last point. There is a time for all seasons. What it means is that in options, you have the opportunity that if you're bullish on the market, you can buy a call option. If you're bearish on the market, you can buy a put option. Then there are various strategies. We'll talk about that in another session, where we'll definitely be having that soon. So we'll be talking about those strategies as well. So options gives you the advantage, because generally if you are an investor, you simply buy and hold. That means in a bear market, you are buying and holding. But in an options and in a derivatives market, you can be a bull in a bull market and a bear in a bear market. So if the markets are bullish, you are on the long side. If your markets are bearish, you are on the short side. So that is the major advantage of derivatives. Then I'll briefly touch upon a key concept called the put-call ratio, PCR, which is called. So what you need to understand is that the put-call ratio is nothing but the total number of puts divided by the total number of calls. And generally we find that the value, average value for the put-call ratio is not 1. Due to the fact that most equity option traders and investors almost always buy more calls than puts, because the biasness is more towards buying. So you will find that the average ratio is often far less than 1 for options. So when the ratio is 1, is closer to 1 or greater, it indicates bearish sentiment. That means more puts have been written as compared to calls. So a higher number indicates a bearish sentiment. Whereas conversely, when the ratio is near 0.6 here or lesser, it implies a bullish sentiment. But many people take it as a contrarian, that if it is extremely low, that say 0.6 or 0.7, what it effectively means is that compared to more calls have been purchased, but at the same time more calls have been written. So so many take it as a contrarian view also. So it depends upon how you view that, but it can be quite helpful. This is now the question is where can you see all this? If you use the Angel Advanced Charting application, you get the put call ratio. Otherwise, you can go to NSE, their homepage, their products, derivatives, equity derivatives, current market reports, and under daily reports, you get this index options, what is the put call ratio, stock options, put call ratio. But stock options put call ratio won't make much be of much use because that includes all the options. Index options, again, I believe it will include both Nifty Bank Nifty, so that again would be of much use, but still gives you a fair idea. So you can use our Indian Advanced Charting application. Those who are interested, you can write to ebroking@angelbroking.com with your client code and you can get it activated. Otherwise, you can also, if you're using the Speed Pro, under the Speed Pro settings, you can go and activate the Angel Advanced Chart. It gives you, as I said, real-time charts of options, futures, all the NSE stocks, and also the currency segment. Lastly, I'll be talking about open interest and its interpretation. So open interest is the total number of contracts or commitments which are outstanding in futures and options. So you'll find that there is a sudden spurt in a particular stock. So you'll find that the open interest OI, which is called, is increased significantly. So what you need to remember here is that if the price is rising, volume is rising and open interest is rising, that's a very strong market. That is, the trend is likely to continue. Likewise, if price is rising but volume is falling and open interest is falling, that means there is a trend reversal or the trend strength is losing its momentum, so there is likelihood of a topping out. Likewise, if price is falling but volume is rising, open interest is rising, what it means is that sellers are even willing to sell at lower levels. So that is a bearish sign. So what it means is that it's likely to continue weak. And lastly, if prices are falling, but now the volume has started falling, open interest has started falling, what it means is that now sellers are not very confident of selling at lower levels. So it means that a trend reversal is likely to happen. This I'm talking more from a technical perspective. You should match price and volume on the charts. So as I said, advanced charts can help you significantly there. And lastly, I would like to add here is what you definitely shouldn't do while trading options. So if you're trading options, what are the don'ts? First is, don't trade without a stop loss. So here you can have your stop loss based on the underlying. So underlying could be the futures, underlying could be the cash. Just having an underlying under the options is not a good idea because the time decay, what could happen is that you buy a call option on, say, for Reliance, and Reliance does not go anywhere the next couple of days. So you'll find that your option premium has started falling. So if the premium you had bought at 10, now the premium has become 8. But Reliance has not gone anywhere. Say it's say just for example, it's at say 1,000. It's not got anywhere. It's trading 1,000. But your premium has come down because of theta, time decay. Now what happens is that suddenly for the next after a couple of days, Reliance goes up from 1,000 goes to 1,020. So your now option which was at 7 or 8 now goes to 13, 14, and you are in the money. So but had you put a stop loss at 8 rupees in the option, your stop loss would have got triggered. So if you're putting a stop loss, so if you're buying Reliance at 1000 in the futures, you should have a stop loss as per the futures. And then you should exit your option position at that point of time. This is something most people don't understand, but this is something which is very crucial. So your stop loss has to be based on the underlying. There is never average a losing trade. So if you're in a losing position, don't average your position, at least in the derivatives segment. That's not a good idea. Then another important thing is being eager to trade in the first 15 minutes of the day. As far as possible, avoid trading in the first 15 minutes of the day. First 15 minutes of the day is reserved for the most uninformed traders. It's because the market digests all the happenings once the market closes till the market opens. So it's a lot that happens. We have the European markets, we have the American markets, and then we have the Asian markets which are trading. So the market digests everything. So let the market settle down for the first 15 minutes and then you should take a position. Then the next is holding on to your option position. Say for example, you have your option trade for days without reason. Because I've seen that many people, they simply buy an option and they say that we'll hold it till expiry. And then they say, okay, and then when on day of expiry, they're not making any money, so they will let it expire worthless. That's not a good idea. Generally, you should see that if you're buying an option, keep a 1-2-3 rule. 1 day, 2 day, 3 day. If within 3 days the option is not moving within your in your direction, you should get out, because option is all about timing, and for timing you have to have some understanding of technicals. For that, as I said, you can use our Angel Advanced charting application. That's free for Speed Pro users. And for that, you need to write us at ebroking@angelbroking.com. Then becoming emotionally attached to one's position. If you take a position and then you're emotionally attached, no, I will not get out till I make profit, till I make money, then that's not a good idea. You should listen to what the market is saying, because the market is sacrosanct. What it says is the final word. That's the final authority. And buying the cheapest options and hoping for a windfall, that's something we need to remember. And that's not a good idea. That what I talked about. And what is the cheapest option? Deep out of money options. So they are deep out of money options. But once a while, it could be a lottery for you. That means you have bought a deep out of money and the market really moves, or the stock really moves in your way, and you make a lot of money. That is something you can do if you know that there is some major news that is to come, meaning the company results are coming, but you don't know what is the likelihood of the result going good or bad, but you have an inclination or you've done some research, and okay, the result could be very good. So you buy slightly out of money option, which is at a very low premium, and if the market moves in your favor, you make a lot of money. So that's something you can do. But as far as possible, avoid plain vanilla writing of options, because that's something which is very dangerous if you really don't know how to exit your position. And in overnight trades, in the next day market opens up with an up gap, down gap, the premium that you have sold, it could be multiples of that which you have to pay back. So these are the certain areas which I wanted to cover. Then we, as I was talking about, we have the Angel products. We have the Angel Advanced Charting Tool, which I would recommend that those who are Speedpro users, they should definitely use this. As I said, you have all these charts, real-time charts for options. There's also something called Options Angel Option Analyzer that's in Speedpro itself. You can have a look at it. If you have any queries, we will address that. In our other webinars, we'll be talking about that in detail. So thank you from my side. Now we can take your questions.